Well, we're so glad that you've joined us. We're very excited about this next piece. This is called The Rhyme of Taigu. It's by a Chinese-American composer named Zhou Long. The Rhyme of Taigu. Taigu is the Chinese word for Japanese daiko drumming. You've probably seen some Japanese daiko drumming. Usually really big guys hitting really big drums. Usually they're not wearing shirts. Tonight we actually, where our guys are going to wear shirts. Come back to the Blake show and we'll see what happens. So this is inspired by Japanese daiko drumming, which actually started in China and then really took hold in Japanese drumming, in Japan rather. And you'll hear that drumming throughout. Daiko drumming in Japanese culture has historically had all sorts of functions. Different rhythms symbolize different things. There would be daiko drumming for farming, and daiko drumming for going into battle, and for prayer, and just about anything in life, could be a daiko drumming thing. And you'll hear what's very distinctive about daiko drumming is not only do they play on the head of the drum like usual, but they'll also click their sticks on the side of the drum. Here's how it sounds at the beginning. It's very cool. Now, this piece is sort of in three movements. It starts very broadly like that, and will gain energy, get louder and louder and faster, and very excited. And in the middle of the piece, you'll hear a clarinet solo. There are actually a lot of clarinet solos in this piece, because it's sort of an imitation of the Chinese instrument, the guanzi, which is a wind instrument, playing high up in its register. It's very cuts through the orchestra. Everything will stop, and you'll hear this clarinet imitating this instrument, which takes us to a slow, mysterious middle section, which is inspired by temple music, sacred temple music of Beijing. And you'll hear all sorts of interesting, beautiful, mysterious sounds, particularly in the percussion section. Like, we have some Chinese tuned gongs. And like a little prayer bowl. And the wind players will do these little falling gestures, which are sort of an imitation of a chant from Chinese. This is that third example. Not gonna do it? Never mind. You'll hear it. It'll sound lovely. That must have left it off the sheet, to be honest. So that middle section, it starts very mysterious, and then it will get pick up speed, and then we'll have a last section, which just sort of calls back. There's lots of energy, lots of drumming. Hope you enjoy. Here's The Rhyme of Taigu by Zhou Long.